Hello once again, everybody. Welcome back to Euro Truck Simulator 2. Now, we find ourselves back in Cardiff, because of course we've had an update, but also because I've installed Promods, because the Promods team have released the update, which allows it to work with 1.25. So, we have to see exactly what's new. Now, I have used it before, but not on this profile. This is the first time I'm using it with the first time I'm using Promods with this profile. So looks like that has changed. It's a little bit up there that's changed, because I have actually made quite a concerted effort to get all of the roads down here. So this junction here is actually fixed between the M4 and the M5. Of course, is a clover leaf like this. Not that really weird junction they had beforehand. So next to Southampton, we now have Portsmouth with its junctions. There's a little bit of change there. Well, that junction there has changed. Yes. See, it's kind of annoying for people who... for completionists, because now I've got all these little teeny tiny... See, like that little teeny tiny stretch of road that's different, which you're gonna have to go around and get again. But what's this junction like? So we've now got Croydon here, just south of London. Got Chelmsford on the way to Felixstowe. See, this road did exist before. We've driven up it before, you know, and we've used this dock. So yeah, it's there. And then we got this really interesting sort of retail area north of London. So that's quite cool. Looking further north, of course, we have the Isle of Man that we can go to. Yes, Scotland doesn't stop at Glasgow and Aberdeen. No, it goes even further north with these up here. And then, of course, we've got Orkney and Faroe Islands. And then, of course, Iceland up there. So, looking over here, it's more or less the same. The Scandinavia area is more or less the same. There's a couple of little changes. There's quite a bit down here. I mean, I did all of Scandinavia as well. But, of course, we got all the way up the east coast. And then Finland. At least I think that's Finland. I mean, look at how far north that is. Where's this one going? Where is that going? I didn't actually notice this on the... I didn't even notice that on the previous... what's the word for it? Previous version. Because, yeah, my previous playthroughs have been pretty much up to here and going around Iceland. So this will certainly be interesting. And then you've got sort of the west coast there. You've got an awful lot more stuff in France, of course. A tiny, tiny section of Spain there. Even Promods hasn't gone to Portugal yet. It's hard to say, really. How far down into Italy did we go? I don't think... Because I think this was the border last time. You know, it really didn't come down here at all. So there's quite a bit around here. Obviously, in our last episode, we finished up here, didn't we? Of course, knocking this off, but we didn't actually get a chance to explore it. So we haven't bought the... we haven't bought the garage, so we can't fast travel there. It's obviously been there before, but all of this over here is new. Well, from my point of view, anyway. So the thing is, what do we want to do? Well, I kind of want to explore the north of Scotland, actually. So, big question is, I mean, the track up to here would take at least one episode, maybe even two. But we do have the garages up here, so we can just start up there. But it depends where anything's going. Now, I do have the Promods real companies and trailers mod, but unfortunately the trailers don't work because something in the update just leaves you with white trailers. The textures don't work, so I've had to disable that. So some of these trailers work with the companies, others don't. It's hopefully it'll be fixed soon. So anything from Glasgow, well, that goes to Aberdeen. That goes to Inverness. We haven't been there, so we could go for that one. Broadford? Oh, I see. Could do that one. So that's 3 hours 50, that's 4 hours 30. I would say, let's fast travel to Glasgow and see if we can pick up some of these. See, that's Douglas. That goes to the Isle of Man, which of course is technically a separate country. It's not part of Great Britain. It's a bit strange. Anyway, I'm not calling the people there strange, of course. It's a lovely place. It's just the legal sort of sovereignty situation is a bit strange. So yes, let's go to the garage. Company manager, that's the word I was looking for. Company manager, and go to Glasgow or Aberdeen, depending. We'll go to Glasgow, I think. So, not options. Why am I going to options? It's company manager I want. Garage manager. There's Glasgow. Quick travel. See, this is why you buy them. This is why you buy them all if you have the money. Yes, it is quick travelling. There we go. So hopefully this won't take too long to load. No, not long at all. Not long at all. So look on the map down there. There's a little bus depot that we haven't explored. So come on, guys. Turn. Oh yeah, that's my low air pressure warning. Now remember, we're in the UK, so we have to drive on the left, because I've been driving in mainland Europe for so long that I'm not driven on the left for quite a while. Oh, shut up. See, at least these vans still work. Delivery van over there. Waiting for the lights. You see that car put his brakes on and then think, no, actually, I'm going for it. That is incredibly well done. It's like, yeah, just light tap on the brakes and he thinks, hang on, I can make this. Perfect, absolutely perfect. Right, so we've explored this now. So we just got to go around. Just finish exploring Glasgow, because it's look at that thing in the middle of the road there. That's weird. That ain't right. Oh, funny little errors. Look at that tower thing there. That's got to be a real Glaswegian landmark. No, they're going that way. It's great seeing real companies in here, though. It really is. So this way. For some reason, this garage here is new. Or at least it's changed enough so that we haven't been there. It's changed since we've been there, that's what it is. Oh, there's a big bump. That is a big bump coming in. So, let's see. We have explored all of Glasgow. Good. Even this thing all the way up here. Even the quarry. So that's been updated. I don't think I actually drove that. I don't think I did. See, that's the thing. When further north you get, It's all these little roads. That one there, I know I haven't driven down. So, yeah, all these little roads seem to change. But I've definitely driven there and there. So anything further north of that is completely new. Let's see, though. From Glasgow, further north. So Inverness, we haven't been. It's pretty much our only option, isn't it? There's Rotterdam, Amsterdam, Liverpool. Yeah, they're all far too long. Manchester. Oh, we could go to the Faroe Islands. Could do. But yeah, we'll go to Inverness. It's a nice little short thing. We'll even go through Fort William. So we're really close there as well. Yes, we'll see, shan't we? We will see. So, let's go. Come on. Reverse, that's it. So hopefully they'll fix the trailers in a future update. I mean, they know it's an issue. It's on the forums. They say they're working on it. So, yeah, shouldn't be too long now. Oh, and I'm still in kilometres an hour, aren't I? No, that's the wrong button, isn't it? I need to use the keyboard for that. Yep, let's change that back. Now, yes, the trouble is, when I installed Promods, it set the currency to whatever they use in Czechoslovakia, CHK, whatever it is. I think. It was something like that, anyway. Let's go back to miles. Which one was it? No, it's CZK, that was it. Yeah. So, I'm not entirely sure why it did that. Because it was definitely pounds beforehand. But anyway, it's all back to normal. We're in miles. We're using pounds. Good. But weight is still in... Weight is still in kilos. And liquids are still measured in litres. Yay, Britain. And it's not quite adoption of... metric. Oh, you weirdos. So, freight market, of course. So, yes, these are stock trailers, so we still have the option. Still have the option of... let's get the double... Let's get that one. Nice. So, take job. Yes, they're still the stock trailers in most cases. Oh, we got very close to that trailer. So yes, let's just reverse up on this now. Try and get it roughly in the middle. Should be now. No? No? Okay, we're not quite. The trouble is, of course, this sort of manoeuvring eats our air pressure. Absolutely decimates our air pressure. There we go. Raising the legs. And we're ready to go. Sweetness. That's it. Pull forward a bit before we start turning. Keeping an eye on that mirror. You see, it's a lot easier to manoeuvre and drive a big vehicle when you can see the mirrors. Fern Bus Simulator, I'm looking at you. See, I can sit here and not have to move my head and still check the mirrors. Well, my in-game head, like this. I could do, but it is very annoying. I don't want to have to do this. I'd rather sit forward, look ahead, and just use my eyes to look sideways. I mean, yes, you need to look sideways there. But that's no problem anyway. It feels great to be back in Euro Truck again. It really does. So we've got about half a tank of fuel. We've got about half of our driving hours remaining. So that's at least 4 hours we've got. Oh, now it goes up to 50. So let's have a quick look at the route, make sure it's sensible. Yeah, it seems to be. Up here, past the quarry, which is still considered Glasgow, even though it's miles away. We could nip down here and get that on the way. I know Squirrel does. Squirrel really likes knocking things off as he goes. Fort William will get. I mean, there's practically nothing there. And just a Stobart depot. And then up here and there. So what's this? That's just a hotel. That's the thing you get in Promods. You do get stuff quite a long way outside cities. Look at this over here. That's brilliant. I want to go up here. I want to explore. I want to see everything. Yeah, that's me in a nutshell. Right, so Oban, Inverness. See, all these signs are updated. So there we go, around the corner successfully. Now those do look like reflective road studs. Not that we can really see them in this during the day. But yes, it's 1:15 in the afternoon. Good time to be on the road. And hey, it's Friday. Rock on the weekend. So, 50 miles an hour. Put the cruise control. Put the cruise control on. And then we can just drive nicely. There's very little traffic along here. I'd have thought there'd be quite a lot, because we're down to 40, are we? Why are we down to 40? Because there's some tight turns. I mean, yes, this one is quite tight. I'll give you that. This one is a fairly tight turn, that's fine. But anyway, it's great not having passengers saying, "You're going too slow." Oh, Fern Bus. Your flaws make me love you. Sounds like an abusive relationship, though, doesn't it? Well, not really. Let's not trivialise domestic violence. Anyway, let's not dwell on these things. Let's get going. So what else is there to see on the route? This is a nice little windy country road. Nothing else happening. I've seen a grand total of one car coming the other way. Oh, there's a guy behind me. There's at least one guy behind me. There's two. I can see two behind me. Well, the speed limit is 40, so you're not going to get much more out of me. Oh, no, there's a truck. So there's two cars and what looks like a van behind me. That is fine. That's fine. So we're coming up to a junction which has been modified, at least enough to make it different. Different enough so it's not the same bit of road anymore. Oh yeah, here we go. Yeah, this is a much bigger junction than it used to be. It was just a fairly plain T-junction. This is a whole business with different lanes and things. Well, that's good. That's good. So we've explored that. Coming up to the quarry. This, of course, it's not the furthest north you used to be able to go, but it's certainly the furthest north of Glasgow. Certainly the furthest north of Glasgow. So they've obviously updated this junction as well. T See, this junction is what it was like back there. But we can... So yes, we're now on brand new road. Well, new to me. Promods has had sort of Inverness and Fort William and stuff like that in for quite a while. Oh, we are allowed to do 50. Awesome. Oh, I keep forgetting speed limits. Is it 50 still? Yes. No overtaking, though. Yeah, I'm not going to do any overtaking. Hey, the sign back there said 50. The sign back there said 50. Urgh. How does that mean it's 40 for us? It doesn't work like that. And watch this go back up to 50 now. There we go. It's 40 again? Will you make your mind up, please? Oh dear. So we've marked that off. We'll do that at some point in the future. And did you see the bilingual street sign? Well, road sign. You know what I mean. Most definitely bilingual. Bit of old Scots Gaelic there. It's a rather nice windy road, actually. It's certainly nicer to drive along here than it is a highway. And certainly a better view. Are we back down to 40 again? I just can't keep on top of all these speed limit changes. Screw you, I'm doing 50. I mean, yeah, this bit of land up here looked fairly plain until we got closer and it started popping in the vegetation. But look, it's nice, man. It's nice. Good little services. I tell you one thing, I would not want to do 40 all the way up here. 40 all the way along here would be a penance. Still on the A82. A little pass along here now. Looks pretty. Most definitely looks pretty. With some more tight turns now. Yeah, we're going to have to slow down. Just a bit though, not ridiculously much. But yeah, windy. Awesome, gives you something to do on the way. Because who wants a boring drive where it's just a straight bit of road for miles and miles and miles? Nobody wants that. They want nice, twisty, interesting roads. So yeah, straight on. Oh, we get to go over this bridge. Oh, that is cool. There we go. Did that pretty much perfectly. 30 miles an hour. At this corner? Yeah, I agree with that. Wouldn't catch me going much faster than that along here. 20 is enough. Oh, well, that lovely, lovely water down there. So, where are we? Geographically, I mean. Sort of at the head of a bit of a valley here, aren't we? Yes. We've got... Well... Let's see. I'd say, yeah, we're pretty much halfway, aren't we? Driver's hours. Looks like we will probably make it. before my guy starts to yawn. We'll certainly make it before we get any fines, so that should be alright. Fuel. Yeah, we'll have plenty of fuel. We've used hardly any. You see the change in the water texture there? That was a bit strange. But anyway, see, all of this, is stuff that enthusiasts have done, and they've done a very, very good job. I mean, look at that church over there, at least I assume it's a church. Fort William, yes. So, I'm going to have to nudge myself into Stobart's. Fort William discovered! It's literally just Stobart. It would be nice to actually have Stobart trailers too, but obviously they don't work. So this is where it gets tricky. It's making sure you're lined up right to get in. Well, look at that! U Benders. It's quite a good name for a plumbing company, actually. Royal Mail van. British Gas. So you haven't got loads of those. So yes, let's try and get our trailer around as quickly as possible. We can't even see the other end of our trailer. But there we go. We turned around. Because, yeah, you've got to remember that the trailer pivots around its rear wheels. Oh dear, what have you done? What is going on over there? So something didn't go well there now, did it? Right, anything coming the other way? Nope. I should be okay. There we go. Yeah, I don't like being out of the cab in this. Because, yeah, the camera sort of floats around behind you and you don't really know which direction you're actually going. I think it's my only criticism. I mean, at least in Farming Sim, the camera's locked. You know, it stays where you put it. So you do get a very good idea of where you're actually driving. Ah, look at this. What an interesting drive. Much better than just being on the motorway for 2 hours, isn't it? I mean, fair enough. The motorway will get you there quickly. But will you have fun? Nah. You'll be held up in traffic and roadworks and get utter knobs, causing trouble. Lovely little lake there. At least I assume it's a lake and not like an estuary or something. Just wish I could go a bit faster. Okay, so I suppose technically I can. Just edge it up just a little bit. Just edge that speed up. 50, there we go. So a lovely little cliff, sort of hill thing next to us here. That's a steep hill to the right. Wow. Ooh. We're going to get a good view from up here. Are we? Oh no, I reckon that is probably the sea, actually. It's big enough to be. Let's have a little look. No, it's not. We're nowhere near the sea. It's probably a bit big lock. So we've got services along here. Yes, that blue bed is filling up. It's filling up quite quickly. Get back up to 50 before we reach this junction. There we are. Oh, it's a bit quick for the road, I suppose, but there we are. That's 40 now. Yeah, that makes sense. Oh, look at this! Look at this junction! Oh, no, wrong button. Sorry! Look at this junction! I haven't seen one of these in Euro Truck Sim. Shut up. Shut up for this. Look at all that traffic behind me. That's great. I haven't seen a junction like that in bloody ages. I am. Shut up. Look at that. The signs have Scots Gaelic on them. I haven't seen a junction like that. That must have been specially made. It must have been specially made. Let's get back inside. Oh, it's 5 o'clock. The sun's going down, as you can tell. It makes these signs rather hard to read until the reflection is at the right sort of angle. That's great, man. I want to see that bed again. I like that junction. If you hadn't got that already. Ooh, look at this. I wish there was a hotkey for the photo mode. Because I want to take a picture. Ooh, is there a little parking area? Can we get in the parking area? No, that looks a bit tight. Let's go to the photo studio and have a good old look, shall we? Photo mode. Oh yeah, that's our truck. That's... How do you actually go any faster? Oh, no, that's zoom. The depth of field is always really cranked down on these things. So that over there looks quite cool. Nice little town village thing. Oh, is it just blurry because it's a low... That is a fairly low resolution texture. Oh well. Oh, look at that. The front of that isn't even... Like... It's not even a 3D model. It's just a cutout texture. Love it. So is this down here. You can't see the wall from that side, but you can from that side. Oh, yes. Yes, we're obviously not where the camera is supposed to be. Look at this, though. Oh, let's get up here. Oh, sweet. Sweet. That wouldn't be a bad shot, actually. I'm going to take that shot. Just aim it up so we haven't got quite as much of the castle in. There we go. I'm going to take it. Click. There we go. All right, let's get back behind the wheel. Keep moving. Ah, oh, so that was nice. That was nice. So yeah, because we're here, we really do have to explore that. I mean, oh look, it's this junction again. Looks as if they're making the most of it. Well, you know, you create one asset, you might as well use it a couple of times. So, do we have a snooze here? It's a bit early by the clock to have a snooze. I mean, we only needed to come here to explore. That's all. Oh dear, have we got some traffic problems? I think we do. Let's quick check that way. Look in there. Two lorries at this junction at the same time doesn't seem to work, does it? This wasn't my fault. This wasn't my fault. Is there anyone on the other side of that? Oh, there is. Oh, you idiots. You idiots. This coach here isn't going to get anywhere just by nudging slightly forward. You know what? Maybe we should go and have a sleep. So if we go and have a sleep, this will have cleared by the time we wake up. Oh, dear me. This coach is definitely trying to push his way round. Neither of them wants to sort of move out of each other's way. Van, all you've got to do... I can't show you with my mouse. Yeah, we've gone red. We'll have to go and sleep. Ooh. See, that's the problem. I'm trying to reverse now. By looking at my thing from the front, and it's not really working. No. Back in the cab. There we go. Got a better idea of what's going on now, you see. So yeah, we're yawning, and our thing has gone red, and there's a massive traffic jam outside, so I reckon we call it a night. Don't you? Yeah. I'm just going to park across all of these bays. All of them. So, stop and rest. Oh yes, it looks like we're it's going, you're late now. Yeah, but I had to sleep. Sorry guys, but I had to sleep. And there was massive traffic outside. So I couldn't do anything about that. I mean, we're not that far away. We're only 13 miles. And yeah, it would have been nice to actually, it would have been nice to get there and then sleep, but that was not an option. That was not an option. So yeah, it's 3:30 in the morning, and the sun looks like it's about to come up. Oh, that's lovely. Of course, the further north you go, the more sunshine you get in summer. Of course, in Iceland, the sky never gets dark. It's a bit strange. And of course, it's very, very accurate. It really is. So, Inverness, not far away. That's 50 miles an hour. I mean, I certainly haven't been to Inverness in real life. Or have I? Have I? Actually, yes, I might have done. I can't even remember where I've been now. So it's this place. Whatever this is called, OB or OBI. I don't know. Anyway, we're here now. I don't know what time you wanted it, but it's here. Yeah, just shove it here. Late? Why, how much? By 5 hours? Come on. Well, I mean, you knew. You knew I needed to rest on the way. I mean, okay, yeah, technically we could have made it, but we were stuck in all that traffic. Ah, lovely. Lovely. So here we are in Inverness. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you guys next time, where we have a little look around. There's not much to see, I don't think. there's a little bit over here, and then there's just at the top of our screen there. So anyway, yes, thanks very much. I'll see you guys next time. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Goodbye.